Hey everybody, it's Eternal Beta. Welcome back to Random Acts of Crafting. It has been quite a while, but I'm still here, still alive, and unfortunately, this is quite a bittersweet episode for a quote-unquote return episode. There have been some, been some talks. As you guys can see, I am currently alone on the server. And even though I've been gone for so long, it does not mean that I have not been playing. I've been playing pretty much nonstop since the last time I recorded an episode. Unfortunately, I've been one of the only ones who have been playing since I recorded the last episode. And there have been talks of possibly resetting the server or just completely turning everything over and starting a new map with mods, whether it be FTB or some amalgamation of whatever mods we decide that we want to use. That being said, if that is coming in the near future, I really don't see any reason to keep any of the secret projects that I've been working on from you guys any longer. So let's go ahead. You guys may not recognize this area, although you may recognize that tree right there. That's a tree that is on top of my base, or more specifically, is on top of the temporary storage area of my base. I apologize if this is a little, the audio is a little weird, guys. My mic is, for some reason, just vibrating. I'm not hitting my desk or anything, but my mic is kind of all over the place. So apologize for that. But anyway, why am I hearing bats? Bats! Bat! Die! Die, 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 die. The hell are you doing? It's not dark anywhere around here. Anyway, like I said, with the imminent reset of the server, whoever knows what's going to happen, I don't feel like I should keep any secret projects from you guys anymore. So the original quote-unquote entrance over there, this is what I have actually set up as the entrance, the quote-unquote official entrance to my base. So let's head on in. See, I was smoothed out the walls here and there. Set up a little entrance way here. Stone slabs and lapis. I actually really like how this came out. If I was going to take this any further, I'd work on getting these torches out of here, probably redstone lamps. But come down here, you guys can see the theme, the birch planks along with these stone slabs, stone brick slab, or stone brick stairs, should I say. So we can go ahead and head down here to an area I know you guys have never seen, to this area. Hey, look, it's a skylight with vines all the way around, and it kind of a, it's almost a temple vibe. I really, really like this area. So this is one of those rooms that was naturally this shape, and I kind of just transformed it into what it is now. You know, lay down the grass, and I also put this water in here, kind of chipped into the wall and made the waterfalls and made the corners into these waterfalls. The other thing that I honestly hope you guys realize, notice, one of the two, is the grass. In addition to doing a whole bunch of work, I've actually updated my texture pack to include things like green grass. This is the old alpha beta green grass. This is something that I have missed a whole lot. My mic is like vibrating all over the place here. I'm sorry. So if my audio this episode sounds really terrible, I apologize. But yeah, green grass. I absolutely love it. I've been doing a lot of work on my texture pack, as I've been saying. I know people have asked for a download of my texture pack in the past, but unfortunately, I really can't provide that because my texture pack is kind of an amalgamation of a bunch of different texture packs. So getting the necessary permissions, I guess, to distribute it is kind of impossible. So, oops, did not mean to get off the Ender Pearls. So I cannot kind of hand out a download of my texture pack. I can tell you that it is the base is the Faithful texture pack. Water is the Vanilla HD texture pack, which is no longer in development. This was actually a huge pain to get the water back to where it should be. Took a little bit of work, but got it worked out. The green grass is from the Ant Venom modification of the Faithful texture pack. Love it. Love the green grass. And there are a few more modifications that I made that I will show you guys in just a second here. So let's go ahead and head down into the base. And you guys will see exactly where this is going to come out. Here. And I decided to do this kind of pattern here of this channel to accent the walkway. I like how it turned out. And come out here. Ho ho ho! What do we have here? It's not finished, of course. So that and that. But this, if you guys remember, this is the area where those two ravines intersect. My temporary storage area is up somewhere up there, up on that path. This area was having me two areas with two ravines intersected. This was one ravine there to there, and another one went from there over to there. And I've been doing a whole ton of work just clearing out this area. I still have that to go and that to go. And I actually want to clear out all that. Although I don't think I'm going to end up doing that now that the server is kind of in jeopardy. But this, take a look at this. This is going to be the main entranceway of my base. I really like how this turned out. Kind of a grand stairway, waterfalls on each side. If you guys look here, I actually didn't cheap on anything. I used cobblestone walls to do the kind of detailing and supports for the stairway. I really like how that turned out. I do. I really do. So I did not cheap on this. I really like how it turned out. And, you know, this whole thing is a little carryover of the GeoFront idea. And I'm really sad that I'm going to have to give it up again. Because I really thought this would be kind of like the fruits of my labor. But, of course, you know, it's vanilla. People are bored with vanilla. I understand. But it still disappoints me. But let's go ahead and take a walk through here. This is kind of... Oh, there's slime there. God damn it. Kind of a main walkway. Hey, you. Die. I do not want your experience or your slime ball. Kind of a main walkway. Over. And what this joins up with is actually my branch mine. Again, the green grass. So here's my branch mine, and here are two extra waterfalls that I've added that I did not show in any previous episodes. The mine has not changed. I think I'll mine out a couple more shafts. Other than that, it has not changed at all. I'm very happy with how this turned out. But one thing I have changed, if you guys notice, before I show this to you, a couple episodes back, I mentioned a couple of torches on the wall right there. It's perfect. The fog is actually doing me well here. A couple of torches on the wall right there that I said not to pay attention to. Well, you should pay attention now. Oh, yeah. Portal. I put a secondary portal right there. And if you guys notice, check out the update to the texture pack. This is a texture pack developed by Misa. And it's a very, it's a much larger, it's a higher resolution texture pack than what I'm normally using. The faithful texture pack that I'm using is a 32 pixel. I think this was like 128. So much higher resolution, but God, it looks fantastic. Absolutely looks fantastic. I could not resist. Nothing up here has changed. All the same. But I just added this portal here. And the reason I added this portal, if you guys remember, if you go that way, you can get back to my temporary storage area. But it's a long walk. And what I discovered was that this is almost directly in line with my other portal. So let's head in here. And I'll show you what I've been up to in the Nether. And oh yeah, this is a brand new room. The portal we just came out of, styled up with some nether brick stairs. And this circular-esque room heads over to my other portal. Let's walk you through here. And oh look, here's my tunnel. And there's my other portal. As I said, this portal was completely in line with my other portal, which allowed me to build this room and just have this quick transportation. Now this goes over to the portal that you guys are used to at my temporary storage area. The other thing I should note that I updated in my texture pack is the lava here. This is also from Misa's texture pack. This lava looks freaking amazing. Now if you guys are noticing here, it kind of jitters a little bit. And if you really stare at it closely, yeah, you can see it. But that jitter actually makes still lava kind of look like it's bubbling a little bit. And it really looks good. So I'm a huge fan of this. Misa, I highly doubt you will ever see this episode. But thank you very much for making such a kick-ass texture pack. So what I took from Misa was the portal and the lava. So let's go ahead and head through here, and I'll show you guys some updates I've made in the Nether. Aside from this, you guys will notice at the end of my path here, it's actually dead straight now, whereas there used to be a stairway right here up to Chris's track. So what I did is actually clear out this area so we have a nice straight track, and make somebody's been in here recently. Petey, I'm blaming you. So as I made this stairway up here, and oh look, it's a Nether station. Bernie actually took the time, I'm gonna give Bernie some credit here, took the time to make railways between each of our quote unquote stations. And I kind of dice, you know, styled up my station here with cobble and nether brick. And the stairway that used to be down there up to Chris's track that he made is actually right here now. There it is right there. And as with all the other tracks, two power tracks, button, boop, off that way. I should also note that I have that way I actually explored a bunch to get some quartz. So of course I did that. Wow, I did it. Fire protection 3. Yep, there it is. Fire protection 3. That's why I went out so early. So now we know what exactly fire protection 3 does. It puts you out a lot faster if you have fire. Anyway, that's Chris's area. So let's head back down here. All that's the same. Let me get off of there. Head back down here. Nice straight track here now. Let's head down here and I'll show you guys real quick what I've been doing. The one thing that I've changed in my office here, you can see the floor here now, is actually the normal checkerboard pattern instead of the nether brick checkerboard pattern. I felt like it was too much. It was just absolutely too much. So I changed it out. I think it looks a lot better now. And so I'm going to go over here and show you guys real quick. I'm going to bow. What's up, magma cube over there? I actually installed this pathway here. I made some adjustments to the Netherwart farm. I believe it's a little bigger now. And installed this pathway so that everything is even. There's a pathway going out from all four sides now, nice and even. Kind of... It quells my OCD, I guess, a little bit to have a full path over here now. And I ended up having to move the nether wart over, but you know, it's not a big deal. So I did that, updated, like I said, that. Unfortunately, as I said, with us probably abandoning this map one way or another, it's probably the last updates I'm going to do to this nether area. It's too bad because, unfortunately, as I said, I left room for another shop here. You see here, I actually left room for another shop. Risen was originally going to make a quartz shop, which I thought would be pretty cool. But that will probably never come to fruition now. So this very well might be my last episode on the server. I don't want to make it my last episode because this is episode 19, I believe. I want to at least get to episode number 20. So I may do something else. You know, it's kind of maybe an overview of stuff that I've never actually shown in videos before. Kind of bittersweet, but... Oh, F you. Let's kill a Ghast just for old time's sake. Haha. Oh, I don't know if I ever showed you guys this bow that I made. This bow is amazing. First piece of equipment I've ever gotten in Minecraft with 5 enchantments. Power 4, Infinity 1, Flame 1, Unbreaking 3, and Punch 1. I actually made this bow with a bunch of books, and I kind of messed up because I put the wrong enchant on first, and it kept me from making this a power 5 or a flame, or should I say a punch 2 bow. However, this bow, having unbreaking 3 on this bow has been amazing. Just amazing. So this is another thing that I'm not going to want to leave behind. But before I go, you know, any wonders came back on a while ago now. And he decided to put something back out in the open that he really should not have. So one way I want to go out on this server is saying that something that is rightfully mine is in my possession again. Can you guys guess what it is? Oh, yes. The dragon egg is mine. Once again. Any wonders? You should have never give me my potatoes. You shouldn't have ever taken it from me. Because you know it's mine. Oh, there's a Ghast right there. Let's go freaking kill him. F you Ghast. Kill him. Kill that one too. No. Die. Got him. That didn't ruin anything, did it? Nope. Okay, so as I was saying, any wonders you should never have taken the dragon egg from me. And I feel it's only right that I go out at the close of this server with the dragon egg. So you will not be getting this back. It's not going to be in the ender chest. It's going to be on me at all times. Anyway, that's about all I have for this episode for you guys. Let's go ahead and go into this portal so I can take you guys over to the temporary storage area. Thank you very much for watching. Thanks for sticking with me. Please stay tuned to my channel, though, because although Rack, as you know, it might be ending, there will be more Minecraft videos, and there will be more videos other than Minecraft. I'm going to be trying out a whole bunch of other series, and I really want to know what you guys think about them. So, again, for anybody who's still with me, thank you guys very much for sticking with me. Over 100 subs now. Thank you very much, guys. I very much appreciate it. Just knowing that 100 people are watching my stuff, that, you know, that makes it all worth it. To know that at least some people are getting entertainment from watching my stupid freaking videos, it really makes it all worth it. So, thank you for watching, and I will see you again very soon. Hey.